How significant is this for just commercial aerospace?
It's particularly significant that it is an American company that's doing it. We've seen lots of other nations try to put landers on the moon, China, India, Japan, Russia. The thing is, of course, that it's where they've landed that is quite significant, because they've gone for the South Pole, and that is where there are some resources, potentially, not least water. They're sure there's ice there. They need to know kind of how much, because if you have ice, you can turn that, if you have water, you can turn that into oxygen and hydrogen, which potentially means you have the potential to create fuel to use the moon as a staging place for elsewhere, or just to send stuff back to Earth. So that landing position is quite interesting.
So who are Intuitive Machines?
Yeah, it's a company that a lot of the people work there worked at NASA. They've been going for about a decade, 11 years actually, but interestingly, they went public through a SPAC. Remember SPACs?
Vaguely.
a lot of those SPACs were sort of, in inverted commas, moonshots. Well, this is an actual moonshot, and it looks as though, it's now going to be above its, list price for the first time in about a year, going above $10, which is the price, of course, that all SPACs go public at. Seems to be benefiting from this. It's not been profitable yet, this company, which will not surprise you at all. But they do have a meaningful contract from NASA for this launch, $118 million it was, and now, of course, there are more launches coming down the pipe. It did launch on a SpaceX rocket, of course. It's just the probe itself that's made by Intuitive.
I mean, it's taken 50 years to go back to the moon.
Yeah, exactly. But, there's less of an impulse for it, right? The space race had some other motives as well. Yeah. It's also incredibly expensive. Something like 4% of the federal budget was used for the first moon landing. It's harder to justify that in the current context.